That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It is Jingle Bell time. It is frozen air time. Also, you know, it is winter time. Hey, I wake up this morning. Wilson is beside himself. As you can see, he's upset this morning. Apparently, yesterday we reported a little bit on some of the happenings in the property preservation industry. It has been confirmed. Vicky Bozer, B-O-S-E-R, Bozer, Booser. I'm not sure if I'm enunciating her name correctly, and if I'm not, I apologize. But I think mispronouncing Vicky's name at this point takes a back burner to what's going on. It has been officially announced the state of Washington, the insurance commissioner, is investigating Vicky Bozer and insurance tech. Unbelievable turn of events. Ladies and gentlemen, today's broadcast, today's little podcast, brought to you by your up-to-the-minute foreclosure property preservation industry news, foreclosurepedia.org. Go on over, take a peek. Also, on the list today, women to work back there in Richmond, Virginia. If you need property maintenance, landscape maintenance, you need a house cleaned, give Kim Savage a call. She'll take care of your needs over there in the Richmond, Virginia area, and also down in the D-Land, Florida area. All your landscaping, property preservation needs under one roof. Team Ironclad. Give Brent Douglas a call down there. He'll get you squared away, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, you know, the voting thing is a deal. I got to say something. Martin Sheen, you're an idiot. You are an idiot. I don't know if you've seen the video of him ranting and raving in fear and everything. There's a reason you have never been awarded an Oscar for your acting. You're an idiot. Joy Behar, you're next on my list. You're nothing but a mouthy Italian broad that won't let a day go by. You're an idiot. Hey, isn't the First Amendment wonderful, ladies and gentlemen? Let me just say this about our election results right now. And I hope Joy Behar calls me a racist, because you're a pig. That's what you are, Joy Behar. You're a pig. I used to have a lot of respect for you. I used to really like you. Your comedy, your stand-up stick was really great. Since what you've done on The View in the last 5 years, you're disgusting. You need to leave the country with Whoopi. You guys need to go to wherever you're going. Trump got elected. You already proved you're lying bitches because you haven't left yet, okay? So shut your mouth. Hey, let's get to some election stuff, though, that are facts. Facts. It's not a fact that Russia hacked the system. That's a lie. That's fake news from mainstream media, New York Times. Thank you very large. But in Chicago, we got to thank Jill Stein, ladies and gentlemen. Jill Stein, you're in the idiot category too, but you're a good idiot because you recalled the vote. And guess what we found? In Detroit, Michigan, ladies and gentlemen, there are more votes than there are voters. In Chicago, Illinois, ladies and gentlemen, 119 dead people voted. Get a load of this. Sit down. Get your coffee ready. 119 people voted 229 times. In Chicago, Illinois, guess who these people voted for? Take a guess. Take a guess. Shillery Clinsanto. That's right. So, Detroit, Michigan. Chicago, Illinois. Was there any question about the Chicago one, though? Really, was there? You know, there were some voting irregularities, but not that benefited Mr. Trump. They benefited Hillary, and she still lost. How do you cheat and lose? How do you cheat and lose, ladies and gentlemen? That is something that every American should have concerns about. Every American should have concerns. The media is controlling this. And whether the Pizzagate story is true or not, I don't know yet. I honestly don't know. But there are a lot of dots out there. And that information is coming from so many different directions. But But I'm going to say this right now. I'm going to go out on a limb and make a prediction that if an arrest is ever made in the Pizzagate scandal, the Russians did it. The Russians are at fault. They rigged the system to get those people to molest children and whatever. I don't know. But like I said, there are reports. It's actually on WikiLeaks as a debunked story. You know what? It's only been out 6 weeks. It's not been out long enough to be debunked, ladies and gentlemen. So don't fall into that. But hey, let's get off the political crap. Let's talk some GMO, Monsanto, and the GMO world. The Hindu.com, it's a publication over in India, and Maharashtra, that is a state in India, but they have put their foot down on the cotton development. The Cotton Institute Center, it's the Cotton Institute Center for Research is what it is. The CICR over in India has said no to Monsanto developing any more cotton outside of their government control. This is a good step, ladies and gentlemen, in my humble opinion. The reason? Something that Vandana Shiva has been screaming about for the last 10 years. Monsanto's assistance has been financially disastrous to the farmers. Okay? This crop, these cotton crops that they're producing over there are supposed to be disease resistant, insect resistant. The cotton is used in feminine hygiene products, and people who don't do anything with the GMO world or eat that kind of food, the women are still finding glyphosate in their breast milk. They're finding glyphosate in their blood. How is it getting there? Feminine hygiene products. That's what cotton is. They use a lot of that cotton in those products. It's been a financial disaster for the farmers. And they want to say correlation is not causation. But when you inject something into a society and a suicide rate goes up, you take that element out of the society, the suicide rate goes down. I think there's correlation and causation. I think that can be tied together. I could be wrong, but Monsanto over in India has been accused of minting money. Monsanto minting money. Let's be clear about this, ladies and gentlemen. Monsanto has made billions of dollars. In 2015, they profited $1.9 billion on glyphosate alone. That's a lot of money. And that's what the reality is. I've been saying this for quite some time, that with the issue of it's not so much, is it bad technology? Is it good technology? I mean, there's all this argument. It's to sell a chemical is what it is. The big ruse that everything's okay is to sell a chemical. It's to sell a chemical, ladies and gentlemen, and that chemical is glyphosate. And I'm sorry, but when you have people like Vandana or Vani Hari, the food babe, a drop-dead gorgeous gal, I think she's out of Florida somewhere, I'm not sure, but she was the one that brought to the public attention, a public awareness that, hey, you know what? We have this weird chemical in our food. It's used as a binder, but they put the same chemical in yoga mats. This gal, I'm sorry, but to me, that's a public service. Now, we have another gal that comes along. Mothers Against Myths or something, she calls it. Her name is Kavin, K-A-V-I-N. Synapathy, and Kavin Synapathy, in my humble opinion, needs to be brought up for child endangerment because she brags about feeding GMOs to her children. And oh, by the way, GMOs, anything, your cornflakes, your Rice Krispies right now, your shredded wheat, I don't care what kind of cereal it is. If that company is part of the Grocery Manufacturers Association, ladies and gentlemen, there's glyphosate in it. Plain and simple. If you're not eating grass-fed beef from an organic kind of place, there's glyphosate in your meat. If you're not eating a pig that was grown somewhere else or grew yourself, you're eating glyphosate. I don't care what it is, ladies and gentlemen. Glyphosate is in everything. There's a reason why Nestle is going around the world and gaffling up water rights. I want you guys to think about this for a minute. Nestle is part of this whole issue. They're going around buying up water rights, pushing people out of their wells. They're doing all kinds of weird things with the water. Why? Nestle's one of the biggest bottled water sellers on the planet. What happens if they pollute our water? What happens if they destroy the water? What did Mr. Trump, what was one of his big messages? We want clean air. We want clean water. There is a way to mine coal. There's a way to burn it. That's clean. We have the technology. Let's not be ignorant about this crap. What happens with the water? There's ways to do things. There are ways to come up and do this fracking. I don't know about the fracking so much, but there has to be ways that are safe, environmentally sound ways. They might cost a little more in the initial startup, and that is what the companies don't want to do. They want to avoid doing it clean. They just want to do it the cheapest, the most profitable way. And make no mistake about it, all that stuff is driven on profits. It's driven on shareholders, board of directors, all that kind of stuff. And perhaps, you know what, and I know the knock on Trump's cabinet right now is, oh, these people have no political experience. I want you guys to all think about something for just a minute. Just take a step back. I don't care what side of the fence you're on. If you're a Democrat, a Republican, an independent, a Green Party person like Jill Stein, find your safe space this morning and take a step back from everything and think about this for just a minute. In my lifetime, and I am really excited about this, ladies and gentlemen, in my lifetime, I have yet to see anybody get elected to the presidency of the United States of America that did not have political obligations. This is what has the Democrats and Nancy Pelosi and our idiot Senator Harry Reid all up in arms. Mr. Trump has no political obligations. Nobody has their thumb on him. He's a wild card, ladies and gentlemen. No political obligations. What's he do? He goes out and he finds a whole buttload of people to put in his cabinet with no political obligations. That is very important, and you need to think about that, and you need to think about it long and hard while you're out there crying for a comfort dog, a safe space, and your coloring book. He has no political obligations. That's what has the Democrats so upset, so pissed off, and screaming about Russia. Screaming about Russia! Russia did not hack this election, ladies and gentlemen. The information that was pushed out was leaked, and there's a huge difference. It was leaked by whom? People inside the Democratic Party. Why? Because they see what's going on firsthand. They don't like it. It scares them, and they want it stopped, just like you and I want it stopped. It's crazy. Anyways, we're going to get out of here today. I'm going to find another Christmas song. I want everybody to start saying Merry Christmas. Or if you're like me I like keeping John Lennon's memory alive. So I say Happy Christmas, ladies and gentlemen. but I say Christmas is what I say. I don't, it's Christmas. And that's an American thing, and that's a good thing. We're going to let Wilson and the Scarecrow there kind of get happy with some Santa Claus Christmas music. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're getting ready for a really, really fantastic Christmas season. I hope you, you're able to share it with your friends and families and have a good time and enjoy things. And let's, you know what? You got to give props to Mr. Trump, regardless of what they say, of what they do. He continues to push on. He continues to push on. He continues to reach across the aisle to people who badmouthed him, who said bad things about him. And what does he say when they talk to him? He says, hey, whoa, wait a minute. I kind of said bad things too, so we're even. That's a true gentleman right there and a very intelligent man. Daniela Posse, she's going to sing us out here with Mommy Kissing Santa Claus. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a good time. Let's all be safe out there. Happy Christmas. Have a great day, ladies and gentlemen. Let's all be safe out there. Oh, by the way, so you don't think I'm a hater, that gal's a lesbian singing this song. Let's have a great day. Let's all be safe out there.